Codenamed Hand in Hand 2008, the military training aims to strengthen the counter-terrorism capabilities of the two armies. During a two-week drill in Chengdu, troops from both China and India will take part in basic training, establish a unified anti-terrorism command, and conduct live-fire anti-terrorism operations.
Through this joint training, we can learn good training methods from each other, which is conducive to improving our capabilities in response to the menace of terrorism. On the other hand, it will promote mutual trust between the two armies and take our exchanges and cooperation to a higher level.
The People's Liberation Army and the Indian Army are both very professional armies. We have a lot to learn from each other. By these exchanges and such exercises, we can achieve a lot of synergy, understanding of each other's procedures, and achieve interoperability so that we can be able to perform a particular operation together under a joint commander. And that will also increase friendship between our two armies.
This is the first military cooperation since the border standoff last year, when Indian troops blocked China's road construction in a Doklam region known as the Donglang region in China. Later, the incident escalated to a military standoff. The border tension lasted for more than 2 months and ended when the Indian army withdrew their troops in August, just before Chinese President Xi Jinping and his Indian counterparts met at the BRICS summit in Xiamen, Fujian. In April this year, the two leaders held an informal meeting in Wuhan City in central China. Both leaders agreed to leave the border talks to the two militaries. In November, both sides held their 21st border issues meeting in Chengdu in southwest China's Sichuan province. China and India reached a consensus to jointly maintain border peace before they solve their territorial disputes. 苏小小, CGTN.